if you introspect and look back, that in January I had made you all aware that there are going to be subtle changes. So in the month of July, I'm actually reminding you once again, if you all haven't made the changes, please make the changes. But these changes can only be made if you are deliberate and you are prepared with an open mind to recalibrate yourself, to redetermine yourself and to re-strategize and probably look into the pattern of your life. And if the changes are to be made, you can make them both personally and professionally. And a gentle reminder that whatever changes you make now, once the Jupiter goes direct in August and Saturn goes direct in September, you will actually see the benefits and you will actually see that how rewarding these changes can be. To add on again, I would say a little contemplation. In July, there are two major eclipses coming in. And there is also the retrograde of Mercury, which actually is advising you that now is the time to contemplate, to introspect, rather than hone your communication skills. So you don't have to be angry, you don't have to be aggressive, you don't have to give it back immediately because your tongue is going to tickle quite a bit. So controlling your tongue, controlling your communications is going to be very, very rewarding. And the best way, rather than feeling stressed out that, oh my God, I, because of the eclipses or because of the Mercury retrograde, I have to again control myself. My answer to you would, no, you don't have to control yourself. You just need to go inward. And probably meditation is the best outlet because it will not only make you mentally stronger, but it will also help you know what is the shape that you want to give to your life for the next couple of years. Virgo, the month of July 2019 for you, you're empty of direct stimulation this month. Therefore, be happy to do good deeds and collect positive karmas. We all need a huge bank account of positive karma. The good energy helps facilitate all our actions, whether worldly or divine. Awakened Virgos do things in a very orderly manner. This month, your energy is released and is liberated. Be mindful not to be impulsive. Always balance your enthusiasm with wisdom. Now, what does the monthly review say? Whatever you've got on your plate, be sure to take time out to do your yoga. You need to stay flexible right now. And if you practice with your body, it'll be that much easier for you to wrap your mind around something out of the ordinary. By the start of this excellent month, you are wrapping your mind around some extremely good situations or the news that you're going to get. Don't forget to keep doing your yoga while you are doing your work. So whether you get time or not, the yoga cannot be mixed. So you might want to move ahead on a very big life project, but circumstances and obligations hold you back. Don't worry. Just go with the flow. Nothing is set in stone, and that's a good thing, as you'll discover when you're going along. A little philosophy, a lot of travel, all this and much more is in store for you. Pack an overnight bag, organize an outing by the 25th of July 2019. By the incredibly wonderful 30th and 31st, you will understand why that outing was so important. You will learn something, meet someone, see the world in a whole new different light. In regards to your love and relationships, the best way to be ready for whatever love and excitement is coming your way out or what you need to grab, you need to do your exercises. You need to swim, run, go to the yoga. You need to stay in touch with your body and be kind to yourself before you're extending your relationships. This love stuff is going pretty well right now. You may want to move forward, but forces beyond your control would be holding you back. Stay cool. Again, at the cost of repeating myself, I would say get into yoga. Ask yourself, what do you want in your partner? Then tell them, Get ready for lots of new impressions, as there is a lot of love in store for you by the 30th and the 31st. Stretch, go for a nice long walk, sit back and enjoy, and probably find a partner who's as enthusiastic as you are, in even in your yoga or in your physical stamina. In regards to your career, you are sure very busy and you have so much going on at work, but does that mean you're thinking of ditching out on your workout? Because that would be a really bad idea. You shouldn't ditch your workout at all. And if you remember at the beginning of the, when I was about to tell you what the month holds for you, I had again said recalibrate, re-strategize, re-discipline yourself, and physical workout is a major part of that. If you want to be productive at your work and if you want to take out much from your work, what you really need to do is be productive of your body first. Once you're productive there, once you're healthy there, the work automatically becomes very easy. So go to the gym before you start your day. It's really important to stay fit. You'll get some good news at work that will keep you really motivated. A big project encounters a few barriers, but you don't have to worry. This is nothing serious. It's just a few bumps on a very, very long road that will have its ups and downs and plenty of smooth sailing too. Everything is more flexible than you ever thought. Travel could open all kinds of doors. Bring your amazing organizational skills. You'll see some of the big payoffs from your travel adventure at work. Life is full of unexpected surprises for you, so be ready to grab them. In regards to your health and fitness, you want to feel strong, you want to have lots of energies, you want to be able to touch your toes with your nose one of these days. Well, start the month on the 1st by setting a couple of serious goals so that you will feel fit and fantastic by the end of the month. Ride your days like a surfer rides a wave all the way into the shore. Sticking with your exercise routine such as it is, while adding a few new things to spice it up, will bring you further along than what you have ever expected in life. For the best days, for your career days, for your honey days, for your money days, and for your love and romantic days, you definitely have to visit my website. Now, this year has been very, very significant because of so many retrogrades and so many shadowy planets that have been hovering around our chart. So it's very important for y'all to revert back to your natal charts, to actually see what talents you were born with, what was your destiny, and how you can re-strategize, recalibrate, and redetermine your goals and your ambitions in life. So this year is like a change which can be definite, a change which can be better for you guys, but only the awareness and then getting the change is going to be beneficial. But if you're just going to expect changes to happen in your life, then chances are those changes may actually not be good. So please be aware of your natal chart. Please go through your natal charts, and you need to know what is the pattern of your life. What is the pattern that the life is taking, and do you need to change those patterns in your life? Because eventually life is what you make it. So the thoughts that you have in your mind are the ones that are going to be put into action, and action is what will determine your fate. So changing your fate, shaping your destiny through the talents, by knowing it through your natal chart, will do you a world of good.